In this third tutorial section, we will take a look at the workflow for making use of the REST API in FME Server to build a web application. This web application will dynamically build a form based on the published parameters inside a workspace, leverage the data upload service to make datasets available to the workspace, submit the job, and handle the results. You can then later style this web application to suit your needs. We will use an example from the FME Server Developer Playground as a starting point for this exercise. The workspace parameters shown in the sample output are not hard-coded in the HTML for the page. They are dynamically generated. This is done through a call to generate form items from the FME Server JavaScript library that leverages the FME Server REST API to send a query to get a list of all published parameters associated with a specific workspace. Open the file in session example and scroll down to the output section. For source file, click the Choose File button. Select a file to upload, and click Upload File. This upload option makes use of the data upload service to send a file to FME Server. The server then returns information about where the file has been temporarily saved on the server. This path information can then be used to set the source dataset path within the workspace we want to run. Click the Run Workspace with Data button at the bottom of the output section to run the workspace using your uploaded file as the source. This button is connected to a function defined in the web application's code called Run Workspace. This function takes the values set for each of the parameters listed, including the path to the uploaded dataset, and submits them to the workspace on FME Server using the data download service. It then captures a response that comes back to the FME Server when the job has been completed, and displays the results at the bottom of the web page. We will now have to configure this demo to run on our own FME Server instance, and with the workspace we have been using for the previous exercises in this tutorial. To use an FME Server web service, the requesting client must be authorized. So far you have accessed the web services using the same web browser that you logged into using the web's user interface. So, the authorization for the web service was already established. However, the web service we're building won't require an explicit login by the user. So you will need a token to authorize the web service calls. Open the FME Server web user interface and navigate to Security and then Users. Create a new user with the username Data Loading, the full name Data Loading Service Account, and set the password to for demo only. Ignore the permissions for now. We will assign these in a role next. Click OK to create the user. In the Security, click the Roles tab, create a new role named Data Loading, and assign Data Loading to the associated users. This is the user we just created. Under Permissions, set the following. Expand Repositories, then enable Read and Run for data upload, and Read and Run for samples. For connections, enable access. Expand services. For data download, data upload, and job submitter, enable access. Click OK to create the role. On the left side menu bar, click on Course. On the Course page, click on Load Template and select Allow Specific Hosts. Delete the existing hosts and add the host from which your web page is run. Click Save Changes. In the top right corner of FME Server, click on your username to open the drop-down menu, then click on Manage Token. Copy the token for use momentarily. Back in the File Upload in Session example page, click on the Download Source button to download the source code. Rename the downloaded file to fileupload.html. Move the file to a web accessible location. It can be hosted by a web server like IIS or Apache. Additionally, you can make use of a service like Amazon S3 to host the page. If you are using FME Server on-premise, you can host the web page from its web server root directory. Move the HTML file into the server location where FME Server is installed. usually your C drive, then program files, then apps. Once there, browse to utilities, then Tomcat, web apps, then root. You can then access the page from the following URL, http://yourservername:yourportname/fileupload.html. Open the HTML file using a text editor and modify the code to point to your FME server instance. Look for the call to fmeserver.init in the JavaScript. Change the server parameter to the URL of your FME server host location and set the token to the one we just copied. Within the code of the fileupload.html file, find the following tag. Change samples to data upload. Then also find this tag, and change easytranslator.fmw to checkfieldstatus.fmw, and save the file. To run the new workspace on the web page, if you don't already have it open, refresh it to see our changes. Ensure that the repository is set to data upload, and the workspace is set to checkfieldstatus.fmw. Upload the weekend playfieldstatus.csv file using the Choose File button and click Upload. Then once the file is finished uploading, click Run Workspace with Data. In this example, all we are doing after the workspace has been run is capturing the response object that comes back from FME server and displaying it on the page. We could easily add some additional JavaScript code to parse through the JSON that comes through the server and create a stylized results page.